Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Infinite Magicraid on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Infinite Magicraid and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Infinite Magicraid. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to open our main browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. You don't need to type it, simply because I provided a link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived at this point on the site of Usitility, where we find here an in-depth explanation on how you can obtain Infinite Magicraid on laptop or computer. We browse lower a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to play Infinite Magicraid on PC. It is now obvious that we have some advantages of preferring this emulator. Then, we are on the way to start downloading the Infinite Magicraid by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do now is to run the executable file, so we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I reduced the web browser to find the installation software much better. The installation software is really straightforward. It contains a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will show you what setup path really does. We basically click it, and then we realize that we end up with here the path where in fact the emulator will be set up. If we plan to modify this directory we need to click on that browse button, and now we select another folder and install the emulator wherever we wish. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I just click on install. Great. The install begins and it is going to proceed in the download of those megabytes that are presented on our screen. After you download it, it could possibly be a little more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go faster or slower, subject to your type of access to the web and according to the efficiency of the emulator hosting servers. Right away they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been started successfully. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will fill up and once it gets into the end, the emulator is going to be launched for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has been started there for the first time. Before we continue on, as now you can see, it has made a couple of icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the one we're interested in. Every time we choose to launch Infinite Magicraid on our desktop or laptop, we double-click this particular icon and consequently run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me conduct the following step, which is actually a must, and this is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is presented. At this point, we are required to sign in. Right now once we're on this page, we must execute this next step which is obligatory. Therefore click on Sign In. At present it announces Checking Info. It could once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, that's why it isn't going to move ahead. In that case, you may attempt to connect to your account after a few hours it's going to very likely be repaired. At present we can provide our username and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email and its related password. As an example you can use the exact same email address you use at the moment in your YouTube account. Thus I am going to provide my data and I'll go back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all, info typed in. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us their twos. We will agree to all of them by just clicking on, I agree. Then, it allow us to save to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected it's going to produce a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play Store is started automatically and completely on its own. To install the application, we have got to visit the emulator desktop by left-clicking the icon designated green-colored. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of this emulator for Android, we see that we find right here the Install Video Game button. We mouse-click on this button. At this point we come with the game app. Let's click now on the Install link that I am displaying now in green. This will launch the software installation. Straight away it will install the video game. It usually takes some time, or perhaps it could be extremely fast. This all is going to depend on the connection to the internet. It's actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this specific option that I am emphasizing in green, that allows you to run Infinite Magicraid for the first time. I am currently on the emulator desktop, and so we are going to just click that new Infinite Magicraid icon that's been provided. That game app is started for the very first time. There we end up with it. I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the volume level of that emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This way we won't use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is simply the first one. We mouse click on this app icon which I am mentioning in green. Then the display screen is maximized, offering one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the case that we choose to run the application in full screen, we click this particular app icon. So we would probably presently be experiencing and enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To leave the full screen setting, just click the F11 key. So we would definitely now play in normal display screen setting. From now, I am on the way to demonstrate you the computer keys mapping, which is certainly rather appealing. This means we definitely will be able to utilize the video game a lot more easily. The very first point is to click this computer keyboard icon. And right now there you will have the ability to get the recommended configurations. I'll go ahead and put the default configuration, however if you intend to change that, you can also do it now with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is fully in our own language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, as an example, in Chinese language. And as a result to set it up in the proper language we go there to the cogwheel. So right here inside of many other settings, we just click the language drop down. We can easily opt for the language we like, Spanish, Mandarin, etc. When the language is selected, we could save, the emulator would restart, along with the video game. The next time we launch it, will of course be in the preferred language. Right now, you can find another information that we have to take into account, and this is that we will get a message from Gmail indicating that a brand new electronic device has been connected to our own Google account. It is going to question us if we are the people who have connected that device. Of course, we should not get worried, considering the fact that emulator is behaving like an Google Android smartphone or tablet. And in order to determine which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model choice. And now we see that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for our video user demo. I hope you appreciated it, specifically that you found it helpful. If that is so, give it a great like, subscribe to our channel, and if you have remarks, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment box down below. You could possibly also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams occasionally, you get it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click on any of the training videos that are appearing on the listing of videos to watch and see you in the following online videos. Bye.